Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will be discussing about what is array, what is use of array and the algorithm which we use to traverse an array. Now what is array? Array, you can say, is a collection of what? Data items, and all your data items should be of what? Same type. For an example, suppose if I've taken one variable called as a and I wrote a is equal to 1. After some times, if I will make it as a is equal to 2, a is equal to 3, a is equal to 4, and after all this, suppose at the end of the everything I print value of c, what will be my answer? Obviously, my value of a is going to be what? 4. It means what? At a time, you can store only one value in a variable. So initially, I had assigned one value to variable a, which was got replaced by 2, then it got replaced by 3, and then it got replaced by 4. So every variable can hold only one value at a time. Now what to do? Suppose in the program, if I need to deal with the 10 variables or 10 different values, then to deal with the 10 different values, I have to declare 10 variables. Every time it is not possible to declare 10 variables or more than 10 variables in a program. It would be very difficult for us also to remember the variable names in that case. So in that case, what I will be doing, I will take only single variable which is capable of holding more than one value into it. And that variable is nothing but what? Your array. So array variable can hold more than one values into it at a time. So you can say array is a collection of values of same data type. Same data type means the values which we are storing into the single variable that should belong to a same data type. If I declare my array as an integer array, then all the values which I will be storing inside the array that should be of integer type. If I declare it as a float, then all the values should be of what? Float type. Decimal values. The integer values won't be allowed in that array. So the definition of array is a list of finite number of homogeneous data element. Homogeneous data element means nothing but what? Here all the elements should be of what? Same type. The element of array are stored in successive memory location. Suppose if my first element I have stored at 1000, then obviously my next element will be getting stored at 1001. My next element will be getting stored at 1002, 1003, and so on. So in the array, we store the element in a such a way that my all elements should get stored one after the other, or you can say they should get stored in consecutive memory location. Every element of array is referred by its index number. For an example, see, suppose if this is array. In this array, I have stored total 8 elements called as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Now every element will be referred by its index number. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3 are called as what? Index. So it means I have stored element A at A of 0. So my A of 0 is nothing but what? A. My A of 1 is equal to B. My A of 2 is equal to C, and so on. And at the end, my A of 7 will be H. So in this way, we store an element in array. Now number of element of the array is called as length of the array, and it can be calculated by using formula length is equal to UB minus LB plus 1, where UB is called as upper bound, LB is called as lower bound, and plus 1. Your upper bound is, it means your upper limit of an array, which is 7 here, and lower bound is lower limit of an array, which is 0. So 7 minus 0 plus 1 is going to be a 8. So the length of this array is 8. It means this array is having total 8 elements into it, and every element is referred by its index number. 0 to 7, they are called as what? Index number. And all the elements will get stored one after the other, that is, they will get stored in consecutive memory location. Now the next thing which we have to study is algorithms. At the beginning of this chapter, we have studied various types of data structure operation. There are total 6 types of data structure operation: traversing, searching, merging, sorting, inserting, and deleting. So for every data structure operation, we have some algorithm. First we will start with the traversing an array. See the algorithm. Suppose if LA is a linear array with lower bound LB and upper bound UB. So let us draw one array. Suppose if this is array where I have total 5 elements into it. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 0 is nothing but what my lower bound and 4 is what my upper bound. Now in this particular array, I will be applying traversing operation. How to do that? That we will see with the help of algorithm. Now suppose in this array, I have the elements called as A, B, C, D, E. Now I will be performing traversing operation on this. What is mean by traversing? Traversing is accessing element of an array only once so that you can proceed. So why you will access the element? You will access the element either to read the element or to write into the element. So how to do that? Initialize a counter, set K is equal to LB. So my counter is LB and here LB means lower bound is nothing but 0. So my K ka value is going to be what? 0. Now repeat steps 3 and 4 while my K is less than equal to upper bound. What is upper bound here? My 4 is upper bound. So I will be repeating these steps till my K is less than equal to 4. Visit element, apply process to LA of K. I will be visiting the element LA of K. Now what will be LA of K? K. The K's value is 0. So LA of 0 is going to be your A. I will be applying process onto A and then I will increment my counter. So my counter will be K is equal to K plus 1. So at the next iteration, my value will become LA of 1, which is B. So again, I will be applying some process on B and again, I will be incrementing my value of K by 1. Second iteration, it will become LA of 2. LA of 2 is nothing but what my C. So again, I will be applying some process onto C and I will increment my counter. I will be keep on incrementing my counter till my counter ka value is less than equal to 4. After fourth iteration, my k ka value will become 4 and this condition will get satisfied. So once your k ka value is less than equal to 4, you will come out of the loop. This is how we apply process onto the array by using traversing algorithm. Thanks for watching the video. In the next video, we will be discussing about the next data structure operation, inserting and deleting, and we will be discussing the algorithms on inserting and deleting. Thank you.